So, in this video segment, we're going to talk about theories of the determinants, or what determines of the real exchange rate. And we're also actually going to talk about real and nominal exchange rate. And before we go too far into our long-run theory, let me go ahead and make sure that I point out we're not trying to explain the short run in this case. In the short run, movements in exchange rates are almost all purely financial. And in particular, depend very, very heavily on short-run interest rates and changes in relative short-run interest rates. So that if short-run interest rates rise in the U.S. relative to some other country, then a bunch of investors are going to want to move some of their money into the U.S. dollar, and that's going to push the U.S. dollar up, and so on and so forth. So a rise in a country's relative interest rates is often due to, or often is going to cause, an appreciation of its currency. It a little bit depends on exactly why there was a rise in the relative interest rates. If it was a rise in the relative interest rates because people thought the country had become riskier and were wanting to withdraw their money, then it would sort of have the opposite effect. But in general, if, say, for instance, a central bank raises interest rates in a country, then it's going to lead typically to an appreciation of the currency. If it decreases interest rates, that's typically going to lead to a depreciation of the currency. Okay. But this kind of thing isn't our main topic for this chapter. And in the long run, we think exchange rates are best explained by the sort of arbitrage phenomena that we saw in the last video segment. And what we call purchasing power parity theory. So purchasing power parity is often written as PPP, purchasing power parity. And remember, that was that idea that arbitrage causes the real exchange rate to go to 1. And you can see why this is called purchasing power parity, because when the real exchange rate equals 1, then buying a hotel room or a ream of paper is equally expensive in all countries. Another way of saying this is, remember that the real exchange rate is equal to the nominal exchange rate times the ratio of the two price levels. So we're predicting, then, that the nominal exchange rate times the ratio of these two price levels equals 1. Or, if we sort of move this around, and we're going to multiply both sides by the price level in the foreign country over the price level in the U.S., we're going to get a prediction. So this term's going to cancel out, because this one cancels that one, and that one cancels that one. We're going to get a prediction that the nominal exchange rate is equal to the foreign price level over the U.S. price level. So that if the nominal exchange rate is 100 yen per dollar, we think that typically, things are going to be about 100 times as expensive in yen as they are in dollars. Or if it's 10 pesos per the dollar, then a hamburger that costs $3 in the U.S. will probably cost about 30 pesos in Mexico. So this is, in many ways, our prediction of where the nominal exchange rate is going to head in the long run. so that in the long run, we think changes in the nominal exchange rate are due to changes in the relative price levels.